I'm Mohammad Sabaaneh, Palestinian cartoonist. I live in Ramallah. I've just finished my master's degree from the UK. I got Chevening Scholarship. I finished my master's degree in illustration at the University of the Creative Art. I published my first book in the United States, in the UK, in Spain. And now I'm working on my second book. It's going to be a comics book, and I will publish the first edition with a Street Noise publisher in the state, and I hope also I will publish it in the UK.
Mohammed, welcome. Thanks for that great introduction. My name is Mark Seddon. I'm in Britain, and I've worked with cartoonists most of my life as a journalist as well, but from the safety of their homes in Britain, where they don't face arrest and where they have license really to draw and say what they want. And I think it's going to be very interesting for people looking at this, because it must be very difficult to work as you have done in an environment where there's no real room for criticism.
Actually, it's boring to be in all of these safe conditions to do your artwork as a cartoonist. I think it's a very interesting point that we are facing all of these things, not just Mohammad Sabaaneh in Palestine. Here in Palestine, we are facing occupation, and actually the Palestinian political parties, they are not with democratical mentality to deal with your criticism as a freedom of speech. And sometimes the Palestinian audience also, not just the Israeli occupation, unfortunately, but also all of the cartoonists in the Arab world, they are in the bad situation. In Syria, we lost Akram Raslan and many of the Syrian cartoonists were expelled from Syria. In Egyptian, a lot of cartoonists, and now, right now, there is a cartoonist in the jail in Egypt because he published his cartoon in his Facebook page. But the problem in Palestine, we are facing all of this condition, the lack of the freedom of speech and also the occupation. And the occupation, they work hard to not just to arrest the Palestinian cartoonist or to draw all of this red line around us. And also they want to demolish our reputation around the world by accusing us as anti-Semitic cartoonists, as someone who is make some incitement against the Jewish people, not the Israeli people, but the Jewish people. And that's because they want to justify their accusation that you are anti-Semitism cartoonist. And that's shame about them, because me, as Mohammad Sabaaneh, my first book, Seth Dobokman, he's Jews, and he introduced my first book in New York. I have a lot of friends from Jewish around the world, and I don't care, actually. I don't know that they are Jewish or Christian or Muslim. I don't care about that. I care about this, the occupation here in Palestine. I faced the Israeli jail for 6 months here in Palestine, and because I wanted to invest my time there in the prison, I spent all of my time inside the Israeli prison trying to do some sketching, not perfect cartoon, because there is no tools and supplement for the art inside the Israeli prison. But I've done some sketching, and I published most of my sketches and my cartoon in my first book, in one chapter about my life inside the prison.
And this book was black and white, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, Mohammed, the interesting thing is that, of course, cartoonists have a special license to poke fun, to be the people who know best about parody, who are able to tweak the tales of people. And powerful people really don't like it, but the best newspaper editors are those who allow their cartoonists to do exactly what they want. But this makes it especially risky for cartoonists in a way, because I think that newspapers around the world, because I mean, well, there's another issue we can talk about, which is that a lot of newspapers have closed, especially in the West, and so opportunities for cartoonists aren't around in the same way that they were. But that special, the license that you have as a cartoonist is a very special thing. A lot of comment writers would love to have that great freedom, but with that freedom comes this chance that you can almost become a target, and you must face that. Do you sometimes, when you sit down to do your work, think, I better be a bit careful because... No, it doesn't...
That's very dangerous because, as you have mentioned, we are not just working as a cartoonist in newspaper. We are keeping our narrative as a Palestinian people to the people around the world and conveying our narrative for the people around the world. If I adopt this censorship and start thinking about that if I draw this cartoon, I have just drawn this sketch, and I think this sketch will be censored from a lot of websites and maybe in by social media, by Facebook, because I'm trying to describe what's going on now in Palestine, how the Israelis surrounding the Palestinian people and preventing them to get the vaccine for coronavirus as a Holocaust. You are putting the people inside the jail and without any tools to protect themselves, to vaccine their people. And now you are leaving all of your responsibility as a occupation to help these prisoners inside your prison. If I adopt this censorship, it's going to be very dangerous for my narrative that I will be conveyed for the next generation and the people around the world.
And yet, Mohammed, from what you're saying, you are effectively facing censorship.
Yeah.
Media organizations out there.
I want to mention something. I don't think that there is a freedom of speech around the world when the topic is Israel. A lot of cartoonists around the world, they faced a lot of problem because they criticized Israel. Steve Bell in The Guardian faced a big campaign, and some of his cartoons were dropped from The Guardian because he criticized Netanyahu, and he was accused as anti-Semitic cartoonist. Martin Ross and my friend, the same thing. Vasco from Portuguese. Antonio Antenas in the New York Times, when he criticized Netanyahu and described his relation with Trump. A lot of cartoonists around the world, they faced the problem because they criticized Israel and they were accused as anti-Semitic. There is no freedom of speech when the topic is Israel. Not just for the Palestinian cartoonists, it is international issue. And that's why now I'm trying to provoke all of these international organizations where they are talking about the freedom of speech, that there is nothing called freedom of speech when the topic is Israel.
Well, clearly, you know, each successive generation has almost to fight the same battles over and over again for freedom of expression, for freedom of speech, for freedom to draw, as you're doing. So I'm kind of interested as to know, you know, what made you want to be a cartoonist when you were growing up? I mean, there are not many opportunities for cartoonists out there, are there, Mohammed? I mean, there just aren't. So what was it for you?
You know, now here in Palestine, we have just three newspapers, daily newspaper, and we have... opportunity just for three cartoonists to work in daily newspaper. But the problem is, because I was growing in Kuwait and Najil Ali was working in Kuwait, and you know Najil Ali, the Palestinian cartoonist who was killed in London because of his art. And my parents used to use the cartoon of Najil Ali to tell me about Palestine. And that's exactly what I need for my cartoon to be used from the next generation to talk about the Palestinian narrative and the Palestinian history. But my parents used the Najil Ali cartoons to tell me about the situation in Palestine. And I do believe that the cartoon is the art for all the people. It is free for the all the people. You can see, you can collect this cartoon from the newspaper without paying money for the artist. And that's why.
But of course, you must make a good living, because it's absolutely right, by selling the originals, as Martin Rose and Steve Bell, all of you. It's so important. But you know, I just think that it must be very difficult, because there are some editors who are very relaxed. They just let the cartoonist, they'd have a talk with the cartoonist. What are you going to do today? What's the idea? Just go ahead with it. There are others who are really quite frightened of cartoonists. You just mentioned Steve Bell there. But of course, in your own situation, I mean, President Abbas of Palestine, this is what people need to know, is that you've been you've been picked on by both the Israelis and the Palestinian leadership. It's an extraordinary thing. And in a way, no British cartoonist would experience this kind of threat to their existence. Yeah.
Not just the Palestinian Authority, but my big problem was with the Islamic movement. I was blacklisted in 2008 because I criticized the Islamic movement here in Palestine, not just the Palestinian Authority, not just Israel. I have a problem with all the political parties, the Palestinian Authority, Israeli party, but I do believe that what I do is represent my people. And that's why I do that. And I will keep doing that because I do believe that what I do now is very important for my people to convey their narrative for the people around the world. And that's why now I'm trying to do all this art project as my second book. My second book is gonna be the first Palestinian comics from Palestine, because I've started this project in the UK during my master's degree. And now when I traveled back to Palestine, I kept just doing that work, because I wanna do this, the second project, just to convey our narrative for the people around the world. It's very important for us as a Palestinian to use the art as a tool of resistance, and as a tool to convey our narrative and our story for the people around the world, because the Israeli trying just to debate the Palestinian people as a just people who just want to kill the Israeli. No, it's not right.